The Max Size Line and the Max Size functions found within the built-ins and the Function Plugins tab within the Tools folder allows us to set max sizes for our fonts. So the Max Size Line, real quick, we'll just review this. And when we drag a font down and put this max size on a font, we can come in here and set our maximum width. So we'll change it to 500. Let's move this over a little bit so we can give ourselves some room. And when I type in here and it reaches that 500 width, it starts to shrink. Now the max size line kind of works the exact same way, except we can use this on multiple lines. So we'll go back and grab some more fonts. I'll get rid of this max size font. And I'll put two other font containers down here. And we'll just move these over to give ourselves some more room. Now the max size line works within a group. So what we'll want to do is actually group these two fonts together, or these two containers, and use this max size on a group. So if we have multiple lines of text, we can use this max size line to affect the multiple lines of text rather than using the max size plugin itself on each individual line or container. So when I click on my max size line function and go into the editor, what we have here is the exact same settings as the max size. It gives us a default X scale, a default Y scale, and a max width. So I'm going to decrease my max width, let's say to around 500. And then when I come into my font editor here and start typing, you can see how it affects both lines of text once one of them reaches that 500 width. This works very well if you have text effects functions on your fonts. So no matter which font that you're typing in, once you reach that 500 width, it's going to affect multiple lines of text.